Hello everyone, in this video I will go over one of the darkest periods of time in all of the Wheel of Time, the breaking of the world. This video will contain some spoilers for the Eye of the World, the Grey Hunt, and the Dragon Reborn. Let's do this. The breaking of the world is an event that saw the male half of the One Power become tainted. This caused all of the male channelers to eventually go completely insane, and because of it, they will go on to destroy and kill much of the world. The tainting of Saidin happened after Louis Theron Telemann, the dragon, decided to go directly to Xia'el Guul, the place where the Dark One existed, to attempt a very dangerous mission. In order to defeat the Dark One and its forces, the forces of the Light needed to do something drastic. So Louis Theron decided to strike directly at Xia'el Guul to try to reseal the Dark One's prison with 7 Quendiar seals, and thus imprison the Dark One and end his influence over the world. To accomplish this mission, Louis Theron took around 100,000 soldiers and 100 male Aes Sedai with him, and after a very long battle, Louis Theron and his forces managed to reseal the Dark One's prison, and not only were they able to imprison the Dark One, but also its 13 Forsaken. But in its final moments, the Dark One left the world with one final gift. The Dark One tainted the male half of the One Power, and it instantly made Louis Theron and his remaining 100 male Aes Sedai go completely insane. Louis Theron returned to his home and immediately killed his entire family. He went on to wander through his castle looking for his family without realizing that he had killed them. After some time, the Forsaken Ishamael managed to escape the Dark One's prison temporarily, and he went to visit his old friend Louis Theron. When he saw that he was insane, Ishamael decided to heal him from his insanity in order for Louis Theron to see what he had done to his family. After being healed, Louis Theron saw what he had done and decided to commit suicide by summoning too much of the One Power. In his resting place, the dragon left behind a new mountain that went on to be known as Dragon Mount. The other male Aes Sedai that went instantly insane with Louis Theron went on to destroy and kill everything on their path, and over time they were joined by more and more insane male channelers. Initially, the female Aes Sedai tried to cure the madness in the male Aes Sedai, but they were unsuccessful. So instead, they began killing or gentling them. This period of time became known as the Breaking of the World, and it lasted for about 300 years. During this time, civilization collapsed, and the geography of the world was completely changed. The insane channelers used their power to destroy continents and oceans. Some male Aes Sedai tried to escape the madness of Saidin by taking refuge in Ogier Steadings. Their hope was that since Ogier Steadings have the characteristic of blocking access to the One Power, they could live their lives without ever touching the tainted Saidin and therefore never go insane. But after some time, these male Aes Sedai could not go on living without access to Saidin, so they decided to leave the Steadings. But before they left, they created the ways for the Ogier. Unfortunately, these male Aes Sedai also ended up going insane, and they added up to the destruction of the world. During the breaking of the world, the female Aes Sedai and some male Aes Sedai that had not yet gone insane from the taint in Saidin managed to rescue some of the most treasured Terangreal, Saangreal, and Angreal. They were also able to leave behind some creations that proved to be very useful in the coming age. They created things like the Eye of the World, Kalendor, and the Stone of Tyr. Kalendor was placed in the heart of the Stone of Tyr, and in order to keep it safe, some very powerful words were placed around it. The breaking of the world finally ended when the last male channeler died. This marked the end of the Second Age and the beginning of the Third Age.